Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is Equation of a Circle Part 1, and in this video we define a circle and derive the equation of a circle with center 0, 0 and radius r. We also learn how to determine the radius from an equation, learn how to graph a circle, and we also learn how to write the equation of a circle centered at the origin by looking at its graph. Before we derive the equation of the circle, we already need to know the formula for the distance between any two points given right here. And remember, it doesn't matter if you have x1 minus x2 squared or the other way around. Okay? Because once you square the number, you'll get the same thing. So either way you want to think of it will work. So you need to be comfortable with square roots. And the distance formula came from the Pythagorean theorem, so you might want to review the Pythagorean theorem and the distance formula first. All right, let's start off with the definition of a circle. A circle is defined to be all points equidistant from a point called the center of the circle. So the center of the circle is not part of the circle. The distance from the center of the circle to any point on the circle is called the radius of the circle. All right, so there's some center, and we'll look at a circle centered at the origin. All right, so let's look at a circle with center 0, 0. All right, that would be the origin, correct? So it's right here in the center. And it has some radius, and if we go out that far, we'll get to a point on the circle. So if you have a compass, those are used to draw a circle. So let's say I go out like that far, and I'll call that my radius. So we also use the letter R for radius. So if I go out that far, I've got a point on my circle. Okay? Now, if I keep doing this, like if I go out over here, R, there's another point on my circle. And if I go up here, R spaces, that's another point on my circle, etc. Oops, I put R in the wrong place. So, as you can see there, what do I do here? All right, green. If I did them all the way around, I would get this green circle. Okay, so this is a circle with radius R. And center, 0, 0. Okay. Now, there's infinitely many ordered pairs on this circle, right? There's so many points, right? All of these points on the circle, right? Infinitely many. I can't fill them all in. So, in general, let's just call one of those points, x, y, right? I mean, there's a zillion points. Just like on a line, there's a lot of ordered pairs. And the center of the circle, I'm going to write down here, is 0, 0. So we know that the distance from 0, 0 to xy is r, okay? Right? That's by definition. So we can use the distance formula, right? Between these two points, 0, 0 and xy. This is a generic point xy. There's infinitely many of them. And we know whatever that is will equal r. All right, so let's use the distance formula. The distance from 0, 0 to xy is this formula. You have a square root. Remember, you do the difference of the x coordinate squared plus the difference of the y coordinate squared, and that gives you the distance if you take the square root of it, right? So, all right, what's the difference? What's the difference of the x coordinates. Okay, here's an x coordinate 0, here's an x coordinate x, so we just subtract x minus 0. And now let's look at the y values right here. We've got y and we have 0, so we could do y minus 0. All right, that's the distance between 0, 0 and any point on the circle called xy. And we know that distance by definition is r. So I'm going to write that equals r. All right, so let's simplify this left-hand side. Inside each parenthesis, let's see, the first parenthesis has x minus 0, so that'll just be x. So I really just have, well, x minus 0 is x, so that's square root of x squared plus, and over here we have y minus 0, which is just y, so we've got y squared, and that is the radius. So actually, the radius is the same thing as the square root of x squared plus y squared if the center is 0, 0. All right, so notice we're trying to write an equation of a circle that has a center of 0, 0. Okay, one last step. Let's square both sides. I square the left-hand side, I get rid of that square root. X squared plus y squared equals r squared. That is the equation of a circle centered at the origin with radius r. That's what we're looking for. So the equation of a circle with a center of 0, 0 and radius r is x squared plus y squared equals r squared. So remember, there's lots of ordered pairs that might be on the circle, but if you put each ordered pair in, right, like there's a certain x and a y that go together and radius, you'll get an equation that is true. So here's our first problem. Write the equation of a circle with center 0, 0 and radius of 3. So we look up here. And the formula is, if it's centered at the origin, well, yes, because it has a center of 0, 0, then we just simply write x squared plus y squared equals r squared. Notice it tells us the radius is 3. So if r is 3, we just write x squared plus y squared equals r squared, or x squared plus y squared equals 9. And this is called the standard form. Right here. X squared plus y squared equals r squared. You'll see it either way. The nice thing about writing it as 3 squared is it's easy to see with the radius, but usually you'll see it written as just x squared plus y squared equals 9. It's easy enough to figure out the radius is then 3. All right, now the next thing it asks to do is sketch the circle. Now, if you didn't know this was a circle and somebody said sketch x squared plus y squared equals 9, what would you do? You'd have to, try to figure out some ordered pairs that work in that equation, right? So we could do that, and that would be the hard way. So the hard way is, make a table of ordered pairs, which is not easy. For instance, you would just have to take this equation, x squared plus y squared is 9, and like try something like, well, what about when I put in 0 for x? What would y be? What about when I put in 1 for x? I wonder what y would be. What about when I put in 2 for x? And you could do it. For instance, when you put in 0 for x, okay, we'd have 0 squared plus y squared equals 9. That's not too hard because that says y squared is 9. So if you take the square root, you get plus or minus 3. What does that mean? That means there's two ordered pairs when x is 0. So watch. That tells you that you could put in 3 and another ordered pair is negative 3. Yay, at least we got 2 for 1. Well, then you could put in 1. 1 for x. Okay, let's do that. Let's put in 1 for x. We'd have 1 squared plus y squared equals 9. So that's 1 plus y squared equals 9. So y squared equals 8. All right, well, that's not as easy to do, but you can still take the square root, and again, still going to be plus or minus. You get 2 for 1. And then you could use a calculator to approximate that. So it's approximately plus or minus, let me check that out. It's about 2.8. All right, so what that means is when x is 1, 2.8, or it could be negative 2.8. So you could see you could like make a bunch of ordered pairs up, and there's more that I could go on. This is a hard way to do it. It takes a lot of time, but I just want to show you that's what it would involve if you didn't know this was a circle. And so, for instance, I would say, well, let's see, let's just at least plot these ordered pairs. I'd have 0, 3, 0, negative 3, right? I would have 1, 2.8. So if I go over 1, I'm going to go up about 2.8. That's pretty high. And I also have negative 2.8, which is, about here. I mean, that doesn't even look like a circle, right? Who knows what that is? So if you made a table and you maybe did 100 points or maybe 40 points, you'd eventually get a bunch of dots and do a circle. But the simple way to do it is look at your center of the circle, which is right here at 0, 0. And if the radius is 3, just go up 3 and down 3 from there, and then go over to the right 3 and left 3 from there. And if you recognize this is a circle, then you know what you get to do. You just get to fill in like this. So that's why it's useful to kind of know what the equation of a circle looks like, centered at the origin, x squared plus y squared equals 9. That's what you do. That way you don't have to make up all these ordered pairs and put in a bunch of values of x and try to solve for y, etc. And by the way, if you try plugging in numbers bigger than 3 for x, you'll find out that you'll get complex numbers, imaginary numbers, so you won't be able to graph them. So notice that the domain x only goes between negative 3 and 3, and y also only goes in between negative 3 and 3 for this example. All right, so we wrote the equation, and if we do it the fast way, really quickly, we can get this circle much easier than doing the hard way. Okay, but that's at least an option if you don't know it's a circle. Always, when you want to graph something from an equation, you could plot as many ordered pairs as you need to finally get a good sketch. All right, here's our next problem. Write the equation of this circle. All right, this is cool. So we know what an equation of the circle looks like when we have it centered at the origin, and lo and behold, the center of the circle is at the origin. So all we need to do is figure out what the radius is. So we look at this picture, and you see it's two spaces in either direction. So we could see the radius is 2. And we know the formula for a circle is x squared plus y squared equals r squared. So we're just going to put in 2. And we will be done. X squared plus y squared equals 2 squared, or x squared plus y squared equals 4, which is the way you will usually see it. Both of these are correct. That's an equation of a circle in standard form. So this is called the standard form because it's easy to tell what the radius is. It's 2. All right, one more problem. Sketch the graph of x squared plus y squared equals 16. Again, if you didn't recognize that this was a circle, we'd have to just try to plot a bunch of ordered pairs. But hopefully you recognize that's the equation of a circle in standard form, centered at the radius. So you say to yourselves, okay, I know the center, I'm going to call that C, is 0, 0. And what would the radius be? Well, it isn't written as r squared, but 16 has to be r squared. In other words, if r squared is 16, then what's r? Now remember, r has to be positive, it's a length, so we don't put plus or minus. R is 4. Radius is 4. So if I want to sketch it, I start at the center and I go 4 spaces to the right, 4 spaces to the left, four spaces up, bam, four spaces down, and that's good enough. We're just sketching it, right? We're not trying to get all the exact order pairs. To do that, you'd have to plug in, maybe a 1 for x and a 2 for x and a 3 for x, if you want to find out exactly or at least closer where all those points are. But this is good. We're just trying to get a basic sketch of a circle, and there you go. So that's now what we've done here is only talk about circles centered at the origin. In the next video, we'll derive the equation of a circle when the center is not at the origin. So we're going to get a little bit different formula. It's not quite as simple looking, but the idea is the same. If we know what the center is and we know what the radius is, we'll be able to write the equation of the circle. And if we're given an equation in standard form, we'll be able to figure out what the center and radius is. So make sure you keep watching these series of videos on equations of circles. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.